I enter it. I stop fighting. I collect my own promise. I collect my own gift. I collect my own blessing. I collect them all. I take them. Somebody say, I take them all. Please sit down. Let me finish this thing. What are you fighting for when all the works are finished before the world began? Now, why is everybody motioning Moses? In Hebrews chapter 4, verse 3, look at it. Hebrews 4, 3. Thank you. Everybody, you need to get this message tonight. Amen. So that I can always fire you up every time you want to fall back into warfare. He said, for we which have believed to enter into waiting, rest. How many of you know warriors don't rest? They are restless. Fighters are restless. Very restless. Scattered everywhere about. Fighters and don't have rest of mind. And nobody invests their money, they're going to look for trouble. Somebody may sit down on the own, go carry water pour on. He must fight by all means. That one has not entered into rest yet. How many of you know once you enter rest, you go rest? Say your neighbor, rest. Oh my God, what a night. Help me tell somebody, rest. Waiting. Look at it, put it up again. Look at it. That's what the Bible says. He said, for we which have believed, where do we enter? Rest. So people inside dream, they see the fight, they go. What is it? Help me tell, say rest. You know the tire. Even WWE wrestlers, they retire. Everybody in the church don't like you. Everybody for your compound don't like you. Everybody for your working place don't like you. Everybody. Only you now you good. Only you. You are the only good person. Everybody else is a bad person. You have not entered rest yet. We need to call you home. Help me call the person. Come home. Come home. Alright, let's finish. Look at what he said. We have entered and rested. He said, as I have sworn in my wrath, if they shall enter into my rest, although the works were finished. From when? From the foundation of the world. We are not called to come and battle it out. Say, I will struggle this thing out. God, give me strength. I will struggle this thing out. He said, hey, now don't you call yourself to me that. Start the job. That's how you roll up sleeve. Yeah, yes. And God is looking at him and say, my son, what thing do you? He said, no, not you. Just relax. Almighty God, relax. And when I finish this thing, I don't need, don't worry. God said, you don't do anything. I said to you before you came, but he said, no. Okay. God will not remove that thing. Give him artificial warfare. That's why I say a lot of people are pursuing imaginary witches and wizards. There's a woman that called me from Germany. I don't know who the woman is. She's a Nigerian. She has been living in Germany for many years. You know. I don't know how she got my phone number. Actually, she sent me WhatsApp. On WhatsApp. She sent me this thing. On WhatsApp. She said, sir, I need help. Help me. I said, who is this? He said, you don't know me, oh, but I know you, sir. Please help me. I said, relax. What is it? You know, once I start hearing that kind of thing, that one doesn't know God. Because God is known in the face of Jesus. And everything about Jesus is finished. Are you seeing it? Because now in him, it's all about promises. And those promises, they are yea and they are amen. So I said, madam, slow down. What is it? Wait, what is it? They say she's a witch, oh, she's a witch, and that she's the one doing everybody. Eh? That everybody not disgrace her. They even pursued her. He said, now look, she feels like just dying. She just wants to die. I said, what do you want to die for? What do you have? I said, are you a born-again Christian? He said, yes, I go to MFM, Mountain on Fire. I said, no wonder. I said, so who are the people calling you witch? He said, the pastor of the church in MFM. He said, she's a witch, oh, in Germany. Association of morons. Confused people. I said, even if you are a witch, your pastor, he doesn't know what to do. Is it to drive you? Is it to cast out the witchcraft and sit you down, feed you with the word of God? He said, I'm a worker in MFM. He said, I've been there for many years and I've been trained in warfare. I said, that's why you're always worried. And I go, war till you not die there. So I said, what do you want from me, madam? He said, help me. Oh, I said, you don't need help. You don't need help. What you need is to move out of Mountain of Fire. I said, the mountain that burn with fire. The Bible says we have not come to the mountain. He said, we have not come to the mountain that burn with fire. Mountain of fire is not of God. Whether you get angry or not, doesn't matter. I'm going to say it again. Mountain. I'm not even going to call it a mountain. I'm sure there's somebody that calls it that. Mountain. I said, can't you see? God is trying to help you. That's why they kick you out that you are a witch. Because you yourself, you've been confused for many years. I said, get out of Mountain of Fire. Come and learn about God in the face of Jesus. I have never said, it has never come out of my mouth, somebody they do me. It's an insult to Jehovah. And remember, a man shall eat out of the fruit of his own belly, the fruit of his mouth. His belly shall be satisfied. Somebody do. That's why you don't hand over your life to somebody be that. And they're going to do the person they go. Even if they are doing, you refuse to say it out of your mouth. God told Isaiah, he said, hey, people are coming. The inhabitants of the land, when I finish with them, he said, they will not say, I am sick. He was talking about us. So even when you are sick, you go to doctor. He said, you are sick. He said, doctor, I can't be sick. But put the injection here. He said, but that's why you want injection, right? Because you are sick. He said, doctor, I can't be sick. It's not possible. But put the injection. He said, the inhabitants of the land shall not say, I am what? I am sick. He said, they shall not say it. You are the one giving your life, your life over to the enemy. Powered to do anything he wants to do with you. And then you come and see somebody to do you. Why wouldn't they do you? When you yourself have employed them to do you. All you have to do is do what is right. The Bible says, he that knoweth to do good and does not do it, it's a sin. It's an error. So if you know what to do and you are not doing it, then the enemy will afflict the person. It's as simple as that. If you have to give offering in the church, give it. If you have to come and sweep church, sweep it. Whatever you know to do that is good, the Bible says, do it. The enemy will not touch you. Peter said, if you suffer, suffer not as the offender. But suffer as an innocent person. He said, then there's a reward. But if you suffer as the one who is the offender, there will be no reward. You will still suffer. I have to make this thing clear to you. I'm not talking to somebody here. So don't go and put your hand inside fire and say it will not burn you. Okay. You know, I was watching this guy. What was this guy's name in Singapore? Joseph Prince. I was watching him last week before I traveled. You know, I just turned on my television and he was there. So I said, okay, let me hear this guy. You know, since everybody say this guy, me and him, we preach alike. As I was listening to him, as a matter of fact, I just on the TV to start talking to him. He just stopped. He said, I want to tell you people something. I want to tell you something. He said, do you know what he's going through? So I became curious. I said, okay, what are you going through? He said, do you know, because it's because he preached grace. He said, some people started spreading rumor that he's sleeping about with women. Just to discredit and to destroy his life and ministry. He said, and he has never slept with one woman before, apart from his wife. I look at him, I wish I could talk to him. I was going to tell him, bring your hand, let's shake hands. You are not the first person they don't talk I'm against. There's nothing against me. I mean, can somebody, I don't know how somebody can sit down in a church, maybe because, look, a lot of people want me to preach about sin. If we preach about the sin, and are you going to depress, pass? You will be so depressed because you are practicing the thing. But we are showing you a way out of sin. Why do you still want to be sin conscious? You can't tell a sinner that he's a sinner. He knows he's a sinner. That's why when a sinner see you, a Christian, taking beer with him, he say, and you say you are a Christian. You see, that means he knows that him is a sinner to take beer. You see what I'm saying? So you don't need to tell him that he's a sinner anymore. Bring him the solution, and the solution is Jesus Christ. So people think because I preach Jesus or I talk about what Jesus has done, that means I'm living a wayward life. He's giving people license. What are you talking about? These are people that don't know anything about Jesus Christ. And they don't trust Jesus. Look, I am not the one that will stop you from smoking, from chasing, or committing fornication or adultery. I'm not the one. It is the Spirit of God that will help you to stop it. Are you hearing what I'm saying? So as I teach you Jesus, the Holy Ghost bring confirmation to your heart. Because whether I monitor you or not, you will still do what you want to do. But as I teach you about Jesus Christ, I commit you to him. Who is able to keep you from falling? That's what the Bible said. Now unto him that is able to keep you from falling. So as I'm teaching you about him, I'm committing him to you in good faith. And look, what you don't do, you don't suspect people to be doing it. It's what you yourself you are doing. Now you go suspect everybody. You know, if I'm a father that chase small girls about, you know, school girls, as my girlfriend, anytime I see any boy near my daughter, I say, you won't catch my daughter? But I see so many of you around Tina, I don't suspect you. Because it's far from my mind. I don't even think about it. You know why? You know, that is not the state of my heart. Even though I know that some of you are eyeing Tina, be very careful. You see what I'm saying? So somebody just sit down and the devil throws something in somebody's mind. That's your pastor, Apostle James. He's sleeping with bam. And look, delusion, Pastor Joshua, is real. You know, I've been preaching about deception firsthand, and now see it in somebody that the thing is really real. You look, you just came up with a lie, and the person is convinced about the lie. A denier. That's heavy, the highest level of hypnotism. I'm telling the truth. And the person is bold. He said, I'm telling you. I know what I'm saying. Apostle James is sleeping with the person. Something that is not, there's no, you know, how should I put itself? Even in the dream. Look, let me tell you people. How you are so beautiful as a female in. I see all the females in this church. The way I see Tina, my own blood daughter. Can you imagine me, God forbid, trying to sleep with Tina? Some pastors may be doing it, not Victor James. Father to the core. You know, the word father, that word, F-A-T-H-E-R, father. I am a father to the core. I have never gotten angry one day, and I slept outside of my house, except I travel. Never. I have never left my children alone.